Hello everyone, I'm Teedring and Turret, and welcome back to Danganronpa 2. Now I am absolutely 100% convinced that Nagito is the culprit who killed Byakuya. I think the cheeky little dick waffle went and tried to pretend it was the Yakuza kid, even though he had the most access to that building. He was the first one in there before anybody else to clean the place up. He could have grabbed the skewer beforehand, which meant that Teru, when he said he only saw four skewers in the beginning, was telling the truth. Because Nagito was there beforehand. I could have found a way under the floorboat and then stabbed Byakuya, and he was also next to the air conditioning controls. So I think Nagito, the cheeky little dick waffle, is the one who killed Byakuya. Without further ado, let's find out.
Are you kidding me?
Hey, what the heck is that mound? When did that get there? Never mind that, how did they even make a mountain shaped like Monokuma? That story might be true after all. There might be an enormous organization involved all this. You mean what Byakuya said before, right?
You are right.
Byakuya, you still needed his knowledge. I can't believe he's dead. What happened to Gundam and Fuyuhiko?
How did you mention it? Because they aren't here yet.
I got it!
I know, they probably ran away.
No way!
Oh, hell no, there's no way I'd let them escape, you know. Look, I dragged this one back over here.
Don't fuck with me!
I'm telling you, let me go.
Hey!
Hey now, if you act in violence, I might just eat you up.
Hey,
Fuyuhiko, what were you doing all this time?
Huh?
Nothing, I wasn't really doing anything. I was just chilling in my room when I suddenly heard that fat bastard got killed. Who the fuck cares about that anyway?
You.
How can you say something so irresponsible?
Do you understand?
We're doing our best to investigate this murder even though we don't want to, just to survive.
Wait!
Mahiru, that's enough. You too, Fuyuhiko. I am so gonna punch you in the face if it's you, Nagito. Dumbass. And I guess we're waiting for Gundam?
What happened,
I am right
sinner.
Here.
Now then,
remember
this
well.
Begin.
Main character arrives when he intends to. Are you going for Gandalf here? A wizard is never late. Huh?
Hey.
It seems you noticed it too. He's got his earring back. If I did, then I'm right.
Well, now.
All right, now that everyone's all together, let's take the secret entrance to the trial field.
Wait! Please, wait a second!
What's this?
My, mon ami. Just what are you doing here? Nobody asked for you.
I...
What?
Do you actually want to join in?
You masochistic.
Do you
want to
taste how powerless you are at the class trial? You're an even bigger masochist than I thought.
Special bleeding service!
Oh well, I'm a big brother who dotes on his little sister. I shall allow you special participation.
See ya later!
I'll go on ahead and wait for you guys, so hurry over.
Huh?
He told us to come, but how do we get there? I don't see any doors or vehicles.
What's going on?
He mentioned something about a secret entrance, was it? Secret entrance? It's going to be in the friggin' heads. What the? Something's shaking.
Ooh, this is dangerous. Everyone, please get down.
Seriously? Come on.
Somebody give up.
No way.
Could it be? Is he telling us to enter it?
What?
Such a suspicious aura, even Crimson Steel Elephant Megazia is trembling with fear.
Oh,
that's so totally suspicious.
Hey.
Forgive me, seriously, just forgive me already.
Hey,
why don't we stop here? I mean, none of this is real anyway. Like, not even remotely.
No way.
There's just no way we'll find the killer.
Stupid.
Complaining won't get us anywhere. If you're really a man, then man up for God's sake. Come this far, we have no choice but to keep moving forward. You're right, there's nowhere for us to run. We need to do it.
Hmm.
If that's everyone's decision, I'll just follow you guys.
Yep.
If this were a video game, it'd have a very high difficulty level. Let's do our best to clear the game. Shaken with fear and nervousness, I hesitantly lifted my feet and stepped onto the escalator. I won't think anymore. If I think, I'll run away. All I could do was stare upward intensely at the escalator as the escalator carried me. When each of us entered Monokuma Rock. Okay, what the hell is going on? Did we just get eaten by a mountain?
Huh?
This is an elevator? I see, this entire rock is an elevator. Once again, Monokuma is doing what he pleases. However, if we've gone this far and made something like this, I don't think he's playing it around. Even so, we're going pretty deep. You're right. I heard an unnerving chattering sound inside my head. I soon realised it was the sound of my teeth. All I could do was purse my lips tightly so everyone else couldn't hear it. There we were, listening to unpleasant roars as the elevator plunged deeper and deeper into the earth. Some time passed before the elevator finally finished descending. And then the elevator door slowly opened. I swear if there's lava in this trial hall, it's going to be so tacky.
Welcome!
Okay, welcome!
Ta-da!
This is the class trial field. How do you like it? It's a special place that will decide your fates.
Why, you?
What the hell is he thinking? Locking us in a shitty looking place like this?
Don't fuck with me!
Are you fucking crazy? Don't mess with me, asshole. Complain all you like. I'm used to it by now.
Yeah!
Come on, you're wasting your time and energy. Hurry up and take your seats where your names are written. It looks like everyone knows, even if we try to resist, it won't change a thing. Just as Monokuma ordered, we all walked towards the seat we had been assigned. From this point on, we need to find out who killed Byakuya. The ultra-affluent progeny, Byakuya Togami. He was overly critical, arrogant, and condescending. He was a bit overweight too. And also, I didn't really like him all that much. He got what he deserved. He also had a strong sense of responsibility. As we were panicking, he accepted his role as leader and tried his very best to keep us together. A guy like him got murdered. The person who did it is one of us. I can't believe it. There's no way I can believe it. If it's really true, we need to find out by any means possible. Because that's our only option. There's no way for us to survive unless we sacrifice the killer. So, this life-threatening trial, billowing with hope and despair, has begun. Hell yes, I would. I don't think I actually have any skills. I has no skills. Okay, let's have a look at our truth bullets again. Victim's body was screwing down a hole, filming near the blah blah blah. Time of death, 11:30. Victim repeatedly stabbed over 10 times between the throat and abdominal region, resulting in death. Body has no other external injuries. Body under the table is face down. I don't understand the importance of the knife at all yet. I certainly do not understand the importance of that. Okay. Let's do this. I'm so nervous. Are you ready? No.
Now then, let's begin with a simple explanation of the class trial. During the class trial, you will present your arguments for who the killer is and vote for who done it. If you vote correctly, then only the blackened will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong person, I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and that person will earn the right to leave this island.
Such a cruel rule.
Before we begin, I'd like to confirm one thing. Is there really a killer among us?
Most definitely! There's no doubt that the Blackened is lurking among you! Such a sad state of affairs, isn't it? By the way, this class trial is gonna be 100% fair, so there's no need to worry!
Does that mean the future ones won't be?
I'm the type who hates favoritism and prejudice. Well, not as much as I hate Monami, of course!
You hate me that much?
Now, let's begin!
You're telling us to begin, but what are we supposed to do?
No complaining, let's just settle this with our fists!
Were you even listening to the rules?
Didn't that Byakuya bastard get killed in the dining hall, huh? Then everyone there is a fucking suspect.
Yeah, what you're really trying to say is that you're not the killer, right?
No shit. You guys went off on your own and started killing each other. This has nothing to do with me.
Huh? What does that mean?
Anyway, why don't we try talking about the most pressing issue on our minds?
Huh. The most pressing issue on our minds?
Where we found the body. It's very strange to find a body underneath the table.
Then, let's start with that mystery.
The reason why Byakuya's body was discovered under the dining hall table. We can start with that, but ultimately, we need to find out who murdered him. We can't do that. No, thinking about if is a waste of time. We have to do this no matter what. So the class trial has finally started. From this point on, simple tutorials are in place. Okay, I'm so nervous about this.
Why was Byakuya's body in a place like that?
His body was underneath the table.
It's gotta be the gaps in the floor, though.
The very back of the dining hall.
After the killer murdered Byakuya, they probably moved the body there.
I don't think that's the case. Okay, that was wrong.
Crap! Why was Byakuya's body in a place like
that? Oh god, it was
the
blood stain. That's what I should have done.
His body was underneath the table at the very back of the...
After the killer murdered Byakuya, they probably moved the body there.
No, because it was only on the table.
The killer moved the body.
Huh? Why?
Because there was only blood under the table.
Try to remember what the body looked like when we found it under the table.
And the blood splatter was all over the tablecloths.
Though there was a lot of blood everywhere, there was no sign the killer actually dragged the body through.
So that's why you think it's impossible that the killer moved the body. I see. I get your point.
And here I thought I had a genius idea.
Too bad you're so stupid and boring and unpopular. Your life is meaningless.
Oh, I hope you die, Shorty.
I respond better to praise, you know.
But if the killer didn't move the body, why was it under the table? Byakuya was probably killed under the table.
What? You think he was killed under the table?
So Byakuya snuck under the table for reasons unknown. And that's when he was killed.
Maybe he had a traumatic incident in the dark when he was a kid or something, and he hid under the table's defense mechanism.
Then, shortly thereafter, we found his body under the table.
That does make sense, but why did he go under the table?
Obviously, he was hiding so he could surprise us. That dude was always a big jokester.
The hell he was? You seriously couldn't tell what kind of person he was?
Maybe he panicked during the blackout and dove under the table.
It's a blackout, not an earthquake. Just because the power went out doesn't mean he'd dive under the table.
That'd be normal for most people. Maybe that's not the case for him.
The reason why is probably connected to what Byakuya was doing during the party, don't you think?
Reason Byakuya dove under the table. If it's connected to what Byakuya was doing during... Okay. I don't think that's it. Oh god, I don't know what it is. I can't remember honestly what he was doing during the party. Wait a second, what was that at the bottom? He was reaching for something. But it just said! Oh my god, is it the flipping knife?
I can prove it with this.
How was I meant to know that?
Probably something to do with the knife we found under the table.
Knife? Oh, you mean that thing that obviously screams, I am the murder weapon!
Byakuya probably noticed the knife was hidden there, so in order to get it, he moved under the table.
He was particularly sensitive to the presence of dangerous items, so I cannot deny that possibility. But how did he notice that there was a knife under the table?
If he knew beforehand, he probably would have done something about it before the blackout, right?
Then... instead of knowing about it beforehand, maybe he saw it right at that moment. Like, for example, he might have seen someone trying to take the knife out from under the table.
No, that's not possible.
What? You seem rather confident about that.
Of course. I have proof to back me up.
This is almost like a real trial!
Okay. Well, logic is not my strong point, so this is going to be interesting.
Byakuya ducked under the table during the blackout. That sounds correct.
If that's the case, during the blackout, Mr. Ham Hands must have seen the killer take the knife.
But it was super pitch black. It was so dark I couldn't see my food.
Byakuya couldn't see in the dark either.
No, that's wrong!
So they were his! They were his!
No, Byakuya was probably the only one who was able to see in the dark.
Why do you say that?
He was using those night vision goggles we found under the table. He could have seen what was happening.
So, are you saying Byakuya was the one who used those night vision goggles?
Yeah, that seems to be the case.
Your reasoning is out of focus.
What? What the hell?
No, that's obviously wrong. It should be the other way around.
Huh?
The other way around?
Seriously? The killer used those night vision goggles, not Byakuya.
That's what I was thinking, but... yes, I was surprised.
Thank you.
Okay. So confused. Please do.
The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
Damn it!
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
I don't know what.
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
I don't know what!
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
I can't back down.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
Damn it, this is bad, this is bad.
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Back down.
Where's your proof that the killer used them?
Because if they use night vision goggles, then they could have killed Byakuya even in the dark. I mean, in reality, so those goggles were a plan to kill or brought them to the crime scene.
Oh god. The drawing came.
Because if they use night vision goggles, then they could have killed Byakuya even in the dark. I mean, in reality, that's what happened. So those goggles were a plan in advance. Killer brought them to the crime scene.
Oh, come on.
Allow me to cut through those words.
No.
Byakuya was definitely the one who brought those.
They were in that extra case. With all the other stuff, like the taser and whatever.
Definitely? But why?
Inside the Duralumin case Byakuya had with him during the party, he found a smaller case for storing the night vision goggles.
Which means we can assume that the night vision goggles were kept inside that Duralumin case as well.
Woohoo! I said assume! Ibuki never uses such clever language.
Oh, I wouldn't have guessed.
Plus, Byakuya was the only one who could have taken the night vision goggles out of the case.
Because he had the key.
He was carrying it around before the blackout in the first place.
Mm-hmm. I see. When you put it like that, it makes sense.
Then, was that knife inside the case too? If there were night vision goggles inside, it wouldn't be weird for a knife to be in there too.
It would be weird.
Because everything in there was self-defense, nothing was
weird,
offense.
Aren't I? At times like this, I'd rather be fantasizing about tonight's main dish.
Ew! You totally mean that in a perverted way!
The duct tape,
I see.
Because it was attached to the underside
of
the table.
Huh? Duct tape.
And on the knife blade, it was attached to the bottom of the table.
They probably hid the knife by duct taping it to the underside of the table.
Oh, so that's why we found duct tape there.
So Byakuya was thorough. Even he couldn't have noticed a weapon taped to the underside of the table.
This may be off topic, but why was Byakuya acting so paranoid?
I can answer that one.
Not only did he bring a self-defense kit, but he had night vision goggles inside the case too.
That's true. He went above and beyond being a little cautious.
Now that you mention it, that applies to the dangerous items he confiscated as well. It's one thing to be a little cautious, but performing a body check is a bit much.
It's because the note said it would be at night.
He probably knew someone was planning to commit a murder.
Are you saying he predicted the murder? Could it be? Was he also in possession of the all-seeing eye?
No.
You think so too, right, Hajime?
The note. That it has to be the note. That's it.
I can prove it with this. Everyone, can you please take a look at this?
Be careful, the first kill will happen tonight. Someone will definitely kill someone.
Hey, the hell is this? Hajime and I found this in Byakuya's cottage. It looks like a threatening letter someone sent to him.
So, who's the someone?
Nobody besides Monokuma would write such a dumb, threatening letter like that.
Wasn't me!
Seriously?
Are you sure?
The only lies I tell are friendly lies!
Those are still lies!
It doesn't matter who wrote it yet. So, Byakuya became paranoid because of this threatening letter?
He probably decided to throw a party because of the letter.
Keep everyone together.
What do you mean? By gathering everyone in one place, he tried to create a situation where everyone could keep tabs on each other. In doing so, he tried to put the writer of the letter in a situation where they couldn't act.
But the letter might have been just a little prank.
As long as he was determined not to let any of us die, he couldn't take that risk. His strong sense of responsibility made him believe the letter was legitimate.
I still think you wrote that bullshit letter. You knew that you'd try to get everyone together, and that was the only place that you could do it safely. And you just happened to know about the floorboards.
He should have told us he received a threatening letter.
If he had, we would have panicked. Byakuya probably knew that too.
So, he tried to do something about it without telling anyone?
I see. Strong sense of responsibility as our leader was his undoing.
Screw that noise! Who the hell wrote that letter?
Well, obviously, the killer.
Is it really one of us? Who is it? Among us, who's the one who killed Byakuya?
Enough already! Show yourself, you coward!
If they were willing to come forward, they never would have committed a murder in the first place!
I still can't believe it. Someone in this room killed Byakuya? There's no way I can believe that yet.
Pardon me. Can I say something, please?
What is it, Miss Sonia?
I regret that I must return to this topic, but I just realized something concerning the night vision goggles.
Mm-hmm.
If Byakuya was indeed wearing those goggles, how did the killer manage to navigate in the dark?
You're right. They wouldn't have been able to see anything without the night vision goggles. But if the murderer had the goggles when they took the knife, then how did Byakuya see them?
Even if the knife bore some sort of mark, it would have been difficult to see it in that darkness.
It had glow paint on it.
I see! What if the glowing paint was the mark? With that, you'd be able to get the knife even in the dark. In actuality, the knife we found under the table and the duct tape stuck to the underside of the table were both marked with glowing paint, right?
Does that mean the killer painted them in advance?
Yeah, because glowing paint just looks white in daylight.
But painting them with glowing paint? It's as if they knew the blackout was going to happen.
Because they planned it, dumbass.
They had to have already known. That's why they used the glowing paint as a mark. Which means whoever set up the blackout is the killer.
That seals it. The killer is whoever was in the office with the circuit breaker.
There was more than one thing.
It was you, Peko Pekoyama!
Peko killed poor Byakuya? Was this island not big enough for two glasses wearers?
I think she was having lady trouble in the bathroom most of the time.
Not the killer. Oh, I guess she's not.
How can you believe her so easily?
But with Peko's height, I don't think she'd be able to reach the circuit breaker in the office.
I don't care about a technicality like that. Peko's the one who tripped the breaker and caused the blackout.
A trip in the breaker directly from the office. Peko was the one who caused the blackout. Is that really what happened? After some bit blue-coloured weak spots will start appearing. If we call the weak spots you've seen up until now argue spots, the blue-coloured weak spots will be called agree spots. When shooting agree spots with true bullets, you need to flip your way of thinking. Instead of arguing that the other person's testimony contains lies or mistakes, please fire the truth bullets that prove the other person's testimony is correct. When your truth bullets merge with their weakness, it will become a logically sound agreement. Yeah, it is pretty hot in here. Okay. So I've got to find who's got this right. I mean Nekomaru, because he needed the battery.
Since Peko was in the office, she could have caused the blackout at any time.
That's impossible.
Huh? Why is it impossible?
Because I was not in the office. Not even before the blackout.
That's where you are.
I agree with that.
You were too busy having lady issues.
Peko is telling the truth.
Don't tell me you're crushing on Peko.
It's nothing like that at all. Nekomaru's account is actually Peko's alibi.
I've been trying to use it many times, but the door just won't open at all. Unisex bathroom.
Someone was occupying the bathroom for a long time shortly after the party started, and it was finally freed up after Byakuya's body was discovered.
Then the person who was in the bathroom that whole time was actually...
Peko.
Everyone else besides Peko was in the dining hall after the party started, right?
I see. So there's no way anybody else could have locked themselves in the bathroom except Peko.
I guess that would be... true.
You locked yourself in the commode? You should have said so earlier!
There's no way she'd actually say that. Gosh, you are so insensitive.
If she locked herself in the bathroom for that long, there's no doubt. Shit. Oh, there's no way she'd admit it. There's no way she'd admit she was taking a shit.
Hey, weren't you guys taught any basic manners, or were you raised in a locker room?
No, I'm sorry.
It's fine. How about we stop talking about this and move on to something else?
I can't believe that possibly a shit or a period is a plot point.
Don't worry, the smell wasn't that strong. I used the bathroom right after you, so you can trust me.
I said it's fine.
But still, you were in the bathroom for a really long time. Did you get food poisoning or something?
As soon as I stepped into the office, I felt this sudden rush of pain in my stomach. Because of that, I was unable to leave the bathroom, including when the blackout occurred.
Hey, how did it feel to... do your business in the dark. Did you get excited?
You pervert!
Seriously, stop it.
But still, your stomach pain. Was that really just a coincidence?
Hey, what's the deal? Don't butt into other people's business, especially if you didn't do any investigating.
I'm only butting in because you fucking idiots are out of your element.
Stop this childish nonsense. Just what do you mean by coincidence?
What I mean is it possible someone slipped her some laxatives?
Laxatives?
If so, the killer could have tripped the breaker as soon as that girl left the office, don't you think?
That is a possibility.
I see. That might have happened.
Did you eat anything weird?
I don't remember eating anything weird. Now that you mention it... You brought food to the office, right? Just a little bit from the dining hall.
So there's the possibility...
There might have been some laxatives in it, don't you think?
Taro Taro cooked the food! How suspicious!
I wouldn't do anything like that! Laxatives would ruin the taste!
Did you eat anything weird?
I don't remember eating anything weird. Now that you met, you brought food to the office, right? Just a little bit from the dining hall.
There might have been some laxatives in it, don't you think?
No, that's wrong!
Because then everybody else would have.
No! It's impossible that laxatives were slipped into the food in the dining hall.
Because everybody else would have had the taste.
Pico wasn't the only one who ate that food. Akane ate some of it too.
If the food had laxatives in it, I'm pretty sure Akane would have had stomach issues as well.
I feel totally fine.
Like I said, the dishes are innocent. Don't go making weird accusations.
I apologize for causing a scene. Ryuhiko should apologize, not you. He's the one who made the laxative accusation.
What the fuck did you say, bitch?
Cease this bickering.
Let's just dismiss Peko's stomach ache as a coincidence and go back to discussing the blackout.
Yeah, yeah. We already know that, you trashy skank. You don't have to tell us.
Oh, you better be the next to die.
Trashy skank?
As long as the murder happened during the blackout, the blackout itself is actually what's important. So we need to make it clear how that blackout occurred.
Who tripped the breaker and how did they do it? If you can't answer that, I'm gonna bop you on the head.
Did they throw a stone and hit it?
I don't think so.
Maybe they used a remote control?
I don't think they did.
They probably messed with the breaker.
No.
It does not have to be the breaker.
They put on too many electrics.
They may have tampered with the power supply and transmitters. Or maybe they caused a power surge?
I agree with that.
It's just as Mayuru said. The blackout was caused by a power surge. Of course, that's not a coincidence. Someone caused it intentionally.
Yep.
Which is why those three irons were arranged to cause the blackout.
And the air conditioning went on at the same time. All the electronics in the place went on at the same time.
And you found them right after the blackout. The irons were still on, right?
So by leaving those irons on in the storage room, they deliberately caused a power surge.
Yeah. It seems that's how the killer caused the blackout.
Stupid fool! Hold on a second, let me speak too!
Okay, Neko.
What the heck?
You say the irons in the storage room were used to trigger the blackout? That's inexcusable!
Huh? Oh great, another one of these. I don't know.
If the irons in the storage room caused the blackout, then for the killer to turn the irons up, you're saying they went all the way to the storage? Then that means everyone who was in the dining hall when the blackout occurred can't be a suspect.
Come on, down.
If the irons in the storage room caused the blackout, then for the killer to turn the irons on, you're saying they went all the way to the storage room? Then that means everyone who was in the dining hall...
No, the irons just needed to be on.
Damn it!
If the irons in the storage room caused a blackout,
come on.
Then for the killer to turn the irons on,
come on. What's the? Why am I not?
You're saying they went all the way to the storage room?
Why is it not?
And that means everyone who was in the dining hall.
Come on, it has to do this.
Damn it!
If the irons in the storage room caused a blackout, then for the killer to turn the irons on, You're saying they went all the way to the storage room? And that means everyone who was in the dining hall.
Damn it!
If the irons in the storage room caused the blackout, then for the killer to turn the irons on, you're saying they went all the way to the... And that means everyone who was when the blackout occurred can't be a suspect.
I can't back down!
Yes!
No, just because people were in the dining hall doesn't mean they're not a suspect.
But the people in the dining hall weren't able to cause the blackout. If the irons caused the blackout...
That's the problem.
Crap!
But the people in the dining hall weren't able to cause the blackout. If the irons caused the blackout... Then the killer had to go to the storage room before that...
Damn it!
Turn on the iron! Now do you intend to take back what you said? But the people in the dining hall weren't able to cause the blackout.
Come on!
If the irons...
Allow me to cut through those words!
The irons are just one reason the blackout occurred. But they weren't the direct trigger. The direct trigger was when the air conditioners in the dining hall and office clicked on.
The air conditioners!
The timers for both air conditioners were set to 11:30 p.m.
11:30 p.m. Mr. Ham-Ham's died around that time, too!
Indeed he did.
I see. When the timers activated the air conditioners, the breaker was tripped and caused a blackout. I see. I understand. Indubitably.
Indubitably?
They probably checked the old building's energy usage in advance and used the irons to nearly max it out. So once they set the air conditioner's timers, they just had to wait until they started up on their own.
If so,
they did.
Even if Pekka was in the office, it still would have been possible to cause a blackout, indubitably.
Indubitably? Miss Sonia, not you too.
Regarding the energy usage, they probably asked Monokuma about it.
Dun dun dun!
Is she right? Such a hateful bear! You deserve to die a thousand deaths!
That's not nice, Monobi.
A thousand, you say? If I died that many times, I might really stay dead, you know?
Shut up! You guys just stay quiet!
I couldn't have prevented the blackout even if I was in the office. Even so, I feel regret. If I was in the office, I could have reset the breaker in time.
You couldn't. You couldn't reach it.
No. The breaker in the office was built into a high area of the wall that's impossible to reach. Resetting the breaker in that darkness would have been impossible, no matter what.
Sounds like you don't need to blame yourself.
Even so, the killer is so sly. I'm starting to worry we may never actually find them.
We have
to. It's all right. You don't have to worry. Because they're just a petty killer, right? They can't defeat symbols of hope like you guys.
Huh?
There's no way everybody will lose now. This little incident will just be a stepping stone for you all.
I want to punch you, Nagito.
In the end, hope always wins. That's what I believe.
Nagito? What happened to you?
Huh? What do you mean?
Well, you have been saying this whole time that there's no way a killer could be among us.
Oh, is that so? Well, let's just put that minor detail aside for now.
It's gotta be him, it's gotta be him.
For now? We found out how the blackout occurred, but the question is, who caused it, right?
You dipshit.
Anybody could have hid and set the timers for the air conditioners. Setting up the irons in the storage room could have been done before Byakuya set foot in the old building.
It could have indeed.
What a shame. Any one of us is capable of that.
No, you were the only one cleaning.
What are you implying?
He's just saying. After all this time, we still haven't made any progress.
Huh? Even though we have been arguing for so long?
Unfortunately, it's the truth. Despite the fact that we've discussed this at length, there's not even one clue that leads to the killer. But that might be because there's no way any of us could be a killer.
It's you. It's you. I've got photographic evidence, you little shit.
Anyway, I have an idea about what we all should do at this point. Has anyone thought about our situation right here? Instead of surviving by doubting others, we Isn't it better to get killed for believing in others?
Doesn't that mean... Are you saying we should all just give up and die?
Nagito, there's definitely something wrong with you.
You guys only think there's something wrong with me because there's something wrong with you.
I'm the only sane person here.
Suspecting each other like this. There's no way that's healthy behavior. Let's stop this already. We don't have to find out who the killer is.
It's you, you little piece of chicken shit.
I can't stand this anymore. I don't want to do this to my friends.
You wouldn't kill your friend, you shit.
I don't want to do this either.
Me too! I want to go home and eat candy!
Stop it. If everyone acts like this, I'm gonna...
Everyone calm down.
We're all friends, aren't we? There's no way one friend would murder another.
If you're not my friend, you might.
Then why did Byakuya die?
Who cares? Let's just give up already. There are no clues that lead to the killer anyway. Not a single one.
That's wrong. I think...
Did you say something?
We've already found a clue that might point to who the killer is.
Yep.
You know who the killer is?
The killer? I don't know. But we do have a clue about a suspicious person. I think.
I see. Then care to tell me...
The photo,
photo. Let's try thinking about how the killer was able to obtain the knife during the blackout.
Didn't we already cover that? They used glowing paint as a mark.
They were also bloody close to the table.
No, not that. I mean before that.
My hero's diagram might be
the diagram of where everyone was standing before the blackout, right?
Mm-hmm. So far, this diagram is the clue. Who the killer is and how they were able to move to the table in the dark, because they were next to it already. As clearly shown in this diagram. First, we need to discuss how the killer was able to move to that table in the dark. The killer probably used something to keep them, to help them move in the dark. Wire goes to the table.
They must have used the desk lamp to move to that table in the dark.
All they had to do was search down the wall.
Desk lamp. I hope you don't mean they turned on a light or something.
The wire goes to the wall where you were standing.
There was a blackout. There's no way the killer could have used the desk lamp.
Of course, there's no way they used the desk lamp's light. The killer actually used the power cord.
I can prove it with this. They didn't turn the desk lamp on. They used its power cord.
Power cord?
They could have felt their way to that table using the power cord, right? By doing that, the killer was able to move to the table and use the glowing paint to find the knife.
Mm-hmm.
And there's only one person here who could have done that.
Who?
Nagito. You.
You're the only one! Nagito, it was you, wasn't it?
Me?
Judging from everyone's positions before the blackout, the only person near the power cord was you.
Mm-hmm.
Which means, the only one who could have felt their way to the table using the power cord was... Nagito!
Indeed it is!
That's just a coincidence!
But still, you had a chance, right? A chance to hide the knife under the table?
When you were doing your cleaning job, you ugly little piece of shit.
I see! Nagito, weren't you cleaning the dining hall all morning? If so, you would have had a chance to hide the knife.
That's...
If you factor in the power cord and the time you spent cleaning, you're the only one who could have done it.
Seriously? That's all just a coincidence!
If it was just one coincidence, it'd be fine. But when it's one right after another...
You cheeky little dick waffle, you confuse them all.
I wonder, is something like that even possible? Could it be?
Did you give yourself cleaning duty on purpose so you could hide the knife under the table?
Now that you mention it, Nagito did prepare the drawing to pick who cleaned the dining hall.
Indeed he did.
You rigged the drawing, didn't you? That's how you got picked to clean the dining hall, isn't it?
I don't know if you're the killer or not, but regardless, it seems that you're suspicious, right?
If that's the case, that strange speech you made earlier, that was part of your plan too.
You got us to lower our guard and tried to hide the fact that you did it, didn't you, you motherfucker?
At the moment, I most identify with Fuyuhiko in this, because I think I'd be just like him in this situation.
Well, just admit it already!
Nagito, tell me you object to this. Frankly, I don't want to believe it either. We investigated together. You were so kind. I can't believe you're the one who killed me. Nagito, say something!
Okay, his switch is being thoroughly flipped. The breaker is gone. We get an electrician in here.
The ultimates are working together to combat the despair of their friend's death. How wonderful. How beautiful it is.
Huh? At that moment, Nagato's eyes. Darkness's eyes shone brightly, as if layers upon layers of darkness were folding into each other. As if hope and despair had been cruelly mixed together.
Let's cut to the chase. You're correct. It was my doing all along. I'm the one who hid the knife under the table before the party started.
But you didn't kill with the knife.
I'm the one who used the power cord to find my way to the table in the dark. And of course, I'm the one who caused the blackout. After all, there's no way I'd knowingly whip out a knife in front of everyone, right?
Is it just me, or does he seem a little nuts right now?
Nope, he's a complete and utter mixed bag of nuts.
But I never expected Byakuya to have night vision goggles. Because of that, we had ourselves a little scuffle under the table. And, well, we all saw how that went. Twist ending like this, I think we can all agree this ended up being a very interesting mystery. Byakuya performed admirably.
Just stop it already! Seriously! What the hell happened?
Don't tell me. Is this your true nature? Were you lying to us this entire time?
Lie? That's outrageous. There's no way someone like me could. You guys, I understand better than anyone else.
What is he, the ultimate trash?
Too arrogant to have dreams or cling to hope. Too disdainful to actually try at anything. I've made peace with the fact that I'm a lowly, stupid, insignificant human who can't do anything right.
Holy crap! He's totally the type of guy who spent his childhood killing neighborhood pets!
He seems like the sort of person whose eyes light up while watching Friday the 13th. Just like me.
That's quite the hobby you have there. But, like, now's not really the time to bring it up.
This guy, is he the real Nagito?
Hey, Nagito! If you were behind all of this, then did you also send that threatening letter?
Yep, I sure did.
I don't think he did.
There's nobody else on this island whose handwriting is that painful to look at, right?
I don't think
But why would you send a threatening letter in the first place?
I don't think he sent it.
I think somewhere deep in my heart, I was probably hoping to find someone who would stop my evil deeds. Well, I bet if that really was my reason, at least some of you would feel sorry for me.
Are you making fun of us?
By threatening Byakuya, Nagito was likely able to manipulate his actions.
Yep.
In doing so, Nagito was able to manipulate everyone to the scene where the murder would occur. Am I wrong?
And by taking out Byakuya, it has the biggest impact because he was the one who was doing this, trying to make sure everyone was safe. It's taken away the one piece of security they felt they had.
That reminds me. Nagito was the one who suggested I guard the office.
Oh, I get it. If Pekka was guarding the storage room, Nagito wouldn't have been able to use the irons.
The threatening letter, along with all your suggestions, was all a trap to manipulate us.
Yep, that's true too. But you're wrong about one thing.
Huh? What?
I didn't need to rig the drawing for cleaning duty, you know?
If that's true, then how did you conveniently get picked for cleaning duty?
I see. Well, there's no way I'd expect you to remember it. A worthless talent for a worthless human.
The ultimate lucky student.
I see!
You're the ultimate lucky student. Then, did you?
That's right. I just trusted my luck. I trusted I'd be picked for cleaning duty.
You just relied on your luck?
It's not just luck. It's true my talent sucks, but I'm still the ultimate lucky student, you know?
Huh? I left the red mark. For someone called the ultimate lucky student, you don't seem very lucky right now.
At the time, Hajime said I wasn't lucky, but it was actually the opposite. I was lucky. That's why I got picked for cleaning duty. Just like I wanted.
Enough. I don't care about that anymore. More importantly, why did you kill Byakuya? Answer me!
Byakuya was a very capable leader. For someone like him to get killed, the despair brings. It's only fitting that you, symbols of hope, should use his death as a stepping stone to shine even brighter. That was my only motivation.
You're not making any sense!
Fine. Let's start the damn vote already. I'm ready to fucking kill this site.
Please! Monokuma! Please, wait!
Huh? The fuck?
Her autopsy.
What are you saying? He's already confessed, hasn't he?
I already know that, but...
If it's only a little, then keep your mouth shut. Your ugly face is stressing me out. It makes me want to puke.
I'm sorry.
For now, might I suggest we listen to what she has to say?
But we know who the killer is.
Simply you listening is acceptable. However, I won't allow this to end with mere play. Now then, let us lift the curtain for our bloody spectacle.
I'm not set to gentle. It's gotta be this.
I think it's strange that...
The killer is so obviously Nagito!
Come on.
He has already confessed.
You know...
Come on, spit it out, Mary.
That bastard Nagito is the one who did it. He killed Byakuya with a knife he hit.
Oh, damn it! No!
Thanks for wasting our time!
Then let's prepare to cast our votes.
It's that last one. It's that last one I got hit.
I think
the killer is so obvious.
He has already confessed.
That bastard Nagito is the one who did it. He killed Byakuya with the knife he hit. No, that's wrong.
That knife might not be the murder weapon. That's what you wanted to say, right, Nikon?
What the hell are you talking about? It's obvious the knife was the murder weapon.
No, because it's too wide for the incisions in the body.
But based on the entry prints on Byakuya's body, the actual weapon should be roughly 5 millimeters in diameter.
5 millimeters in diameter? That's like way skinnier than a knife!
Hey, that better be true. If you screwed up, I'll sell your fucking ass to a whorehouse!
Not a whorehouse!
Hey, why are you threatening her?
Is this what you're trying to say, Nikon? As long as we can't prove that the knife is the murder weapon, we can't assume that I'm the killer.
What are you saying? No one else can be the killer. It has to be you.
I think it's the right killer, wrong method.
Hey, don't blame me. Nikon's the one who said it.
I'm sorry.
Hey, Nagito. Are you still hiding something?
Huh?
Hiding?
Like, during the blackout. Did something happen between you and Byakuya that we don't know about?
Who knows?
After all this, what else do you intend to hide?
Jeez, the moment your back's against the wall, you get all silent. You piss me off!
What happened during the blackout?
Yeah, because it can.
If you cross your eyes like this, it gives you double vision!
So it does.
Don't get distracted! Our lives are at stake, you know?
Huh? Whose life is at stake?
Seriously, how long is it gonna take for you to understand the damn rules?
Nobody can see in the dark, no matter how hard you think about it. The truth is beyond your sight. Don't you think that's a pretty clever metaphor? Despite the fact that it came from me?
No, that's not it.
Not it? What's not it?
You don't have to see, but you can hear. Ibiki's account. Oh, it's somewhere up here. There you are.
I can prove it with this.
Even if we couldn't see what happened in the dark, I'm pretty sure someone could have heard it.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that right, Ibuki?
Oh, real?
No, Hex was surprised.
You were the one who told me, remember? Why everyone was shouting during the blackout?
Yeah, come on.
Everyone, calm down. We gotta stay calm in a situation like this.
Ah, don't step on my feet.
What the hell? What's going on here? This is...
Ow!
Turn the damn lights on. I can't eat like this, you know.
You guys? Where are you? Wasn't the blackout just in the kitchen?
Perhaps the breaker overloaded?
Hold on a sec. I'll go along the wall and do something about it.
Such perceptive hearing. Impressive. I'd expect no less from the ultimate musician.
It's a good thing your ears are awesome because your face, style, figure, and personality totally suck.
Like you've got anything to talk about.
You've cut me deep with your knife of truth.
However, after hearing what Byakuya and Nagito said in the dark...
What the hell? What's going on here? This is...
Ow!
It almost sounds like... Byakuya fought back against Nagitors.
Well, that's actually what happened.
He's got a wound.
As a sign of respect for Ibuki's talent, I have a small confession to make. I was actually shoved out from under the table by Byakuya.
He shoved you out?
Just as the blackout occurred, I hurried to duck under the table and grab the knife. But Byakuya, wearing his night vision goggles, caught me and shoved me right out from under the table. That's right. I'm so incompetent that I couldn't even grab the knife.
So Byakuya stopped him when he was trying to get the knife. And he got shoved out from under the table before he could even grab it. Well, it sounds plausible. I mean, just from listening to what they both said at the time. The reason he put the carpet there. There's a trap door or some shit.
What the hell? What's going on here?
This is...
Ow!
They could interpret it like that. No, actually. Now that I think about it, that sounds like exactly what happened.
After getting shoved out from under the table, I was just as confused as you guys. I lost sight of the glowing paint. I didn't even know where the power cord was. Before I realized it, the lights had come back on, and Yakuya's body was lying under the table.
Hold on! Are you saying you're not the killer?
From the very beginning, the idea to throw a party, hiding the knife, setting up the blackout, it was all going according to plan. But unfortunately, my plan failed. And all thanks to Byakuya's night vision goggles. What happened after that? Even I don't know.
You failed?
Then you're not the one who killed Byakuya?
Then we're right back to square one!
How can that be? We spent all this time talking back and forth!
What other word is brimming with so much despair?
But you can't give up. You need to have hope. Do your best and move forward.
The thing is, I hate is that what we're actually just doing is wandering along here the path he's given.
Rising to the challenge again and again is what.
Is Nagito really not the killer? Is this guy really the Nagito I knew before? No, there's no way I can say that. I just thought I knew him this whole time. I didn't know anything about this guy. I didn't know his true character. It's as simple as that. But now's not the time for me to dwell on that. We need to find Byakuya's killer by any means possible. How did Thingy get his earring back? Because if we don't, we will die here. Class trial suspended.
Well now.
Now then, the class trial has reached its climax, but... Okay, here's a question for you.
What's this?
For those of you who figured out who it is, how about you try out the Guess the Killer challenge? Whoever fails to guess the right killer will have their save data melt away like butter. You guess right, I'll reward you with $10
billion. 10 billion?
So those of you who don't know who the killer is, you can just continue.
Now then, what are you gonna do?
Just kidding, you can't make a choice. There's no way you'd be able to guess who the killer is.
And of course, there's no $10 billion either!
You're so evil!
Villain, you are truly a villain!
Yes, I bloody well would. I think that is a great, great place to do his end this episode for today. I have no idea what's going on anymore. Is there a trap door? Is there something under that carpet under the table? I don't know what's going on. I'll find out next time. I'm Tea Drinking Turret, and I hope to see you all next time. Bye.